Welcome. Yeah, it's time to groove. It's time to move, y'all. I'm saying like this, yeah. We grooving, we're moving, we're grooving. Amigos, top 20. We're grooving, we're moving, we're grooving. On Big O's Top 20 Show, grooving, we're moving, we're grooving. On Big O's Top 20 Countdown Show, we're gonna jam, we're gonna slam, we're gonna groove on Big O's Top 20 Show. We're gonna jam, we're gonna slam, we're gonna groove on Big O's Top 20 Show. Yo, 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 it's time for the jam. It's time to get a jam on, you feel me? Yeah. Yeah, it's time to jam. It's time to get your groove on right now. Oh, yeah. Yeah, it's time to jam. It's time to get your groove on right now. On the Big O's Top 20 Show. Yeah. Time to get your groove on, y'all. We back, baby. Yeah. Time to relax. Time to let it go. Time to get your groove on, y'all. It's time to move. Time to groove. Big O's Top 20 Countdown. It's time to groove. Time to move, time to let the beat help you soothe. It's time to jam, time to pam, it's time to slam on Big O's Top 20 Show. Yeah, yeah, Big O's Top 20 Show. It's Big O's Top 20 Show. Yeah. It's time to jam. Time to pan. Time to let the beat help us land. Time to move. Time to groove. Time to let the beat help us sue on Big O's Top 20 Show. Season 6. It's time to jam. It's time to slam. It's time to get your groove on, help your pam. It's time to move, it's time to groove. It's time to let the beat help you soothe on Big O's Top 20 Show. Top 20 Show, baby, yeah. Slam, it's time to slam. It's time to get your groove on, help your pam. It's time to move, it's time to groove. It's time to let the beat help you soothe on Big O's Top 20 Show, baby. Welcome, welcome, welcome to part 2 of 250th episode, y'all. I am so, so happy. Oh my gosh. You guys, we're going to count down number 9 to number 1 of our top 20 guests, man. You guys, this is just so fantastic. But you guys, let's get it started with one of my songs, one of my favorite songs. It's by Kool & the Gang. It's called Celebration. Let's get into it. Celebration by Big O on Big O. So 20 Countdown. Kool & the Gang, baby. Yeah.
Celebration. and have a good time.
Celebration.
We gon' celebrate and have a good time. It's time to come together. It's up to you. What's your pleasure? It's a celebration.
Celebrate good times, come on.
Let's celebrate. There's a party going on right here. A dedication to last throughout the years. So bring your good times and your laughter too. We gon' celebrate and party with you. Come on now. Let's all celebrate and have a good time, yeah, yeah.
Celebration.
We gon' celebrate and have a good time. It's time to come together. It's up to you. What's your pleasure?
Everyone around the world.
Come on!
Yeah.
It's a celebration.
Yeah.
It's a celebration.
Celebrate good times, come on.
Let's celebrate. Come on now.
Celebrate good times, come on.
Let's celebrate. We're gonna have a good time tonight. Let's celebrate. It's alright. We're gonna have a good time tonight. Let's celebrate. It's alright, baby. We're gonna have a good time tonight. Let's celebrate. It's alright. We're gonna have a good time tonight. Let's celebrate. It's alright.
Yeah, y'all, that was a celebration by Cool in the Game. This is a really celebration. This is part two of our 250th celebration. We're going to give you a recap of the people that we featured. The number 20 feature was our boy Blasto. We love him. The number 19 of one of my favorite shows was Raymond Canal. We played his music last week. Number 18, was 100 Mil Pretty. We played his music last week, and we played his interview. Number 17 was a tie between DJ Big Black and Bruce Lemon Jr. We played their stuff, and we also played their interviews, plus we played a song by me. Number 16 was Ferrillo and Jay LaCon, their episode, and I featured them. Number 15 was Bo Ryan, the awesome, awesome Bo Ryan. We played some of his music as well. We also played Ferrillo and Jay LaCon's music as well. And then we did the extra song of the week, which was me, my first single called Triumphant from my new album. Number 14 was Rare Breed. He did his thing. And we also played his music. We did number 13 was Abraham Bouche. We played a song from his son's tribute album, Buddy. And number 12 was Daniel Campos Cannon. We played his interview. Plus, we played another song from Abraham Bouche's son's Buddy's tribute album. And the Comedy Corner featured the awesome Abraham Bouche. Number 11 was the awesome St. James. We played some of his interview, plus we played his music too. And number 10 last week was, wow, Bryce Hayden. And that song was, we did his interview. And we did a snippet of interview, and we did a freestyle last week. If y'all missed the freestyle, man, y'all missed it. But it's time to get into, you know what? We're going to start this off with the extra song, with the second extra song. We're going to start this off with a song. Let's do a song. Before we get into the number 9 song, we're going to get to a extra song. Let's get into it's going to be the second single from my album. This song is called J-O-Y. Let's get into it on Big Ol' Stop 20, 250th episode, part 2, baby.
I got this kind of joy that makes me want to dance, y'all. Y'all ready? Yeah. Yeah. Come on, y'all. We got to dance for God, y'all. It's all right, y'all. We got the J-O-Y, y'all. The J-O-Y, y'all. The joy, y'all. Yeah, I'm going to say it like this. I got the J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me dance and dance and dance and dance. I got the J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me dance and dance and dance and dance. Yo, I got this kind of joy that relieves all my sorrow. I ain't even got to deal with no mess. All I got to do is just go down on my knees and pray to God. And he relieves all my sorrow. Because I got the J-O-Y, y'all. I got the J-O-Y. I got the J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me dance and dance. And dance, and dance. Y'all, even when things are not good, even when my pockets are low, all I gotta do is just keep smiling, keep the joy on my face. Cause I know God will work everything out, y'all. And he's on the throne, y'all. And he's on time, y'all. I got that joy. I got that J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got this kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me dance and dance and dance and dance. I got the J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me dance and dance and dance and dance. Come on, y'all. Dance with me, y'all. You gotta dance for a minute. Get your groove on, y'all. Get your groove on. Get your groove on for God, y'all. Hey.
I got the J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me dance and dance and dance and dance. I got the J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me J-O-Y. Got the kind of joy that makes me dance and dance and dance and dance.
Y'all, let's get a groove on, y'all. Dance with me, y'all.
Don't be scared. It's alright.
You got that joy? I got that joy. I'm saying it like this. Hey.
I got the J-O-Y.
Yeah, we did it, y'all.
Yeah, y'all, that was the second extra song of the week. Yeah, man. But y'all, it's time to get back into this countdown of my favorite artist This is part two. The number nine artist was actually is my producer, actually one of my very favorite producers that I've worked with, and he also did also appeared on the show so many times. He appeared in various episodes. This is one of the episodes that he was on. His name is Carl Anthony, and I believe he was on the first season, the second season, the third season, and I believe this was the second anniversary of the show. So let's play it. Let's play his episode, some of his episode on Big Old Top 20 Countdown, number nine of my top 20 favorite artists.
What's going on with you, Mr. C?
Nothing. You know, I mean, my name's Mr. C, the Enforcer. You know what I'm saying? I'll be on the Instagram at Poppy Carlo and whatnot. And my friends, my crew, we do films and things and comedy and skits and working on my music. And my crew is called the Skit Bags. That's the main group. So check them out on Facebook or YouTube. We do films, full movies. We got a movie out called Head Thieves coming out this year. Another movie out called Scramble. Another movie out we just had in Tribeca called The Clapper. And also another movie called Deported. So we got a lot going on this year. We just scored some skits and we're going at it. The Skit Bags and Mr. C.
All right now. Tell us a little bit more. Give us a little bit more.
Well, yeah. Basically, what's going on is we're building a crew of people, like a Happy Madison kind of situation, where we got about 50 to 100 people of talented people of all types. We the new coming up guys. We the entourage cats of the city. You're going to see us around. Everybody in comedy knows who the Skit Bags are, and soon you will, too. And that's what we're doing.
So how long have you been doing this, acting, and you also do music too. So how long you been at it?
Well, with the music, I started out with music first, actually. And I started out late in life as a musician. I didn't start really taking music serious until I was 25. Before that, I just freestyled with my friends.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. So after a while, I did that for a few while. I learned it from the ground up, learned how to record myself, learned how to mix the songs, learned how to do everything on some low level Kanye West janky style and whatnot, but I was talented as a rapper, and I learned how to sing, and then doing that, I started doing videos for my friends and small films for my friends, and then we run the Arizona Black Film Festival Award for a movie called Monster and a Half, where a girl like gave all these guys AIDS, and I was one of the guys, and I had to beat her up.
Wow.
Because I found out she gave it to me and whatnot. It was like this movie called Monster and a Half.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, met Bill Dukes and everything. It was dope. It was some bougie black folk up in there.
Wow.
Anyway, you know what I'm saying?
That's a major debut right there.
Yeah. And
Bill Duke, he's still around, isn't he?
Yeah, Bill Duke's still around. He ain't gone yet. They ain't got him yet. He ain't on down the list yet. He about four people down the list from corruption. Like, he raped only 13 and a half people. Okay. So, you know, he got time. He got time. They got to get down the list. They got to kill like six or seven more Negroes. and a couple of Caribbean people, too. Y'all watch out, too. Don't y'all better watch out back, too. They out there.
Uh-oh. Speaking of Caribbean, let's go back to the countdown. What's up? We's back, y'all.
Yeah.
That was Damian Junior God Marley with what's the song called? War Fee a Cause.
Yeah.
Not War for a Cause, War Fee a Cause.
Yeah. Banga 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 banga.
Oh yeah, I like that banger. That banger one had me like daga 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 daga. I don't know what the heck he was saying, but it's like
banga banga banga.
he was really seriously trying.
Oh, now he wasn't playing.
He wasn't playing.
He wasn't playing at all.
So what's going on, the Enforcer, Mr. C?
Well, I mean, you know, same old stuff and whatnot. You know, of course, we're gearing back up. I just did some recording today for some new skits we're making. Of course, I'm always recording musicians like yourself and a couple other gentlemen like Capsy and D-Money and several other artists, Z and Holiday Inn and several other people. Tone the Manager out in Vegas doing a really great job and whatnot. To shout out to all his albums. The new album, Aggressive Echoes, out there grinding. Look at that guy, Diverse Entertainment. And we about to put out these films, and we about to do the Hollywood thing. That's what's going on, and I'm kind of like the grimy guy, you know what I mean? I'm like that dude in Entourage that was like the Johnny guy, like the brother that could cook, and he was like a really shitty actor.
Yeah,
that's me and whatnot. But I'm really nice and cool, and everybody likes me, and I work hard, and it's going to work good. And I got some guys with me that are phenomenal.
Yeah.
And it's going to be great, and we're just going to keep growing and building and making good music like we're listening to tonight, like this wonderful reggae music.
Reggae music. You know what? Because, you know, I always try to do something a different genre to keep the listeners, you know, interested. You know what I'm saying? You want to be just saying, oh, we're going to play this type of music. We're playing it all. You feel me? And, you know, speaking of music, today's our 1 year anniversary of our single.
Yeah, that's Uplifted. Right. Congratulations to that.
Yeah, we did it. It did pretty good.
Nobody hold me down.
Yeah. Oh, you know what?
Yeah, that's the jam.
I might sneak the song in. You never know. That might be the gospel song of the week.
Oh, shoot. There
hold
it is.
Up. Hold up. Ooh. Hold up.
Ooh, hold up. On you, the DJ.
Yeah. I like it because I get to play. Sometimes I get to play other people's music, but I also get to play my music.
Yeah. That's how you got a good one. You got to give it to the people.
You feel me? Yeah. But speaking of good music, let's get into. Before we get into music, talk a little bit.
Well, you know, everything out here is about grind. It's about hard work. Like recently, I'm a transplant here from Philly and whatnot. So I moved out to California after I did all my stuff and getting into film. And now I'm out here in the film with my guys doing it on a higher level. And I'm in Philly and I really love L.A. And I've come like a sideways Clipper fan because I like the underdog, right? Yeah. So they've been losing. They're about to get out and everybody running away from them. And I was like, you know what? And this is something to teach you something about life. I said, when everybody else is running to escape the darkness and fear, trying to hide from it, you want to be the last person standing there in the last little bit of light still fighting. And that is how you get what you want in life in any kind of way. Stand there, stand strong, work for it, believe in what it is, especially when it's true. And what is deserved will come.
That's tight. Wow, that's some good advice. That's some good advice.
Yeah, go get them, y'all.
Write that down and put that somewhere.
Oh, it's on Facebook. I threw some quotes around that. Put me at the end of it.
I'm sitting there looking at your quotes, and I'm like, wow, some of the things are right on. I'm like, how do you know? How do you talk? We talk, but not
that. You know why? Because I see some fool out in the street doing something stupid, saying something stupid. They walk by me, just say something dumb. Yeah. And it just clicks in my brain like, no, gee. Then I just get all like Socrates, like a man does not amongst water unless he wants his feet to get wet.
I
guess that means don't be hanging around a lot of hoes unless you want whole problems to come along with it. You get what I'm saying?
That's the truth. That is the honest to God truth. But that's the truth. You better say that, bro. Let's get back in this camp before we go. Well, that was a very, very awesome Mr. C. He was on the show. Like I said, he was on the show numerous times. Right now, what he's doing right now, he has his own Twitch show, and he's working on his own. He also does comedy. He still does comedy at the Comedy Store, and he's doing a lot right now. But you know what? We're going to play one of his songs. This is one of his songs. The song is called Love Story featuring Big Crows. Let's get into it. Love Story featuring Big Crows by Mr. C, Carl Anthony, on Big Ooh, Stop 2250, episode part 2.
Oh why, the lies you tell me? Oh why, I'm cold and lonely. Hold me one time, babe, and I'll be yours forever. Just shake you out of my head.
Yeah, call it who's the whiskers. Batter than bitch niggas. Pull up strong vehicle. The dripping hard ridiculous. Baby, stop holding my strap. Full energy of a cat. Always be closing the track. Nah, man, the block is hot. 12 gun and block, don't shoot your shot. Ha, yeah, my baby keeping it cool. Balance and got it a rule. Protecting my baby a fool. The game is me knowing the blues, ha. You're gonna lose, nigga. Because you fucked around and slept in fucking stills, nigga. It ain't who you are, it's what you fucking do, nigga. You fuck niggas ain't never had a clue, nigga. I'm always on my Nick Cannon, call me Jill, nigga. I want your figure, hey.
Come on and kick it with me. The scavengers love bottom feed. Just call me a guy for the sea. Don't you know who the fuck you are?
Reincarnate energy from distant star. Fuck this, fuck that. Rather running Jason Chuck that. Things that make my babies buzz back. Wildest niggas take gats out your hand. Be so blind and got tricked by Obama plan. Rosen like Dan, swagger hoodies made for stopping under Ku Klux and Klan. See it, fuck you niggas talking about. Always traveling that bumpy round. God damn, man. Yeah, you niggas fucking it all. Pushing on the magic bodies. Stay on the call. It ain't over, little nigga. What the fuck you gonna do? Every day is new awakening, nigga boo hoo. Jordan wanna punch you in the face by your number two. Don't wanna punch you in the face by your number two. Don't wanna punch you in the face by your number two. My T's for two. That's you with the loving in me. My T's for two. That's you with the loving in me. Drink. My T's for two. That's you with the loving in me. My T's for two. That's you with a loving in me. Drink.
Wow, that was Mr. C and featuring Big Crows. That was song. It was called Love Story. He was a number 9, but now I'm the number 8. This episode was filmed, it was done on my birthday back in 2007. This was the first season we had the pleasure of having both Mac B and Ronan Gray on the show, and they came to the party, and also Blasto and other people came to the party, and I got to meet a new friend, Nocturnal, who came to the party as well. But this is just a snippet of their interview, Mac B and Ronan Gray. Let's get into it. They are the number 8 guests. The number 8 of my favorite guests on the Big Old Stop 20 Countdown.
Still big.
Real talk. Every day is a blessing.
You know what I'm saying?
Waking up. We take that for granted.
Thank you. That's the truth, brother.
Hello.
That's the truth, man. So what's going on with you? Say a little bit. Talk a little bit. Say a little bit.
Man, I'm just hustling. You know, my name is Mac B, in case y'all don't know. Some of the people know me as Fatal Mac, formerly Fatal Mac. But I'm in the building just here to support my homeboy, Ronan Gray. But I'm working on a new album. I'm excited. I got a new project. Got a lot of new things coming, writing a script. Still doing the acting thing. So working on a TV pilot right now called Simply Sarah. So just hustling as always. You know what I mean? Y'all know what time it is. All my L.A. hustlers, West.
I'm sitting up here having a good old time. I don't care if one or two people are here. I'm having a good time because the Lord let me
see. Man, what are you talking
see.
About one or two people? It's packed all the way out to the hallway, man.
Yeah. It feels like one or two people.
You know what I'm saying? You're lonely, huh? You could be in a crowd of people and you're still lonely, huh?
Yeah. Speaking of lonely, I'm not going to do that to you, brother. What's going on with, you know what? This is time for the extra song of the week. You know what's going on? You know what the extra song of the week is?
No, tell me. What is it?
R-O-N-I-N. What's my name? No, it's
G.
Me. It's by myself.
G-R-A-Y.
I need to make a song like that. Oh,
I just spell my name out because sometimes, you know, people, you know what I'm saying? So.
I'm going to make a remix of that. O-L-U.
That's right.
They're going to be like, stop
That's
it.
Classic hip-hop, stop though. Spell your name out when you're doing the rhyme, you know?
Yeah, that was, hold on. You know, I started to do this, you know, before.
But you know what? The episode wasn't over. I ended up making Ronan Gray do a freestyle. So let's listen to his freestyle that he did. Listen on Big Old Stop 20 Countdown.
You know, before we do that, we're going to do a freestyle. You want to do that?
Okay. Yeah. I'll freestyle something. It won't be too elaborate or nothing like that. I just have some fun. No problem.
Yeah, man. I don't know what beat to use though. There's a lot of good beats.
Just do some acapella. It doesn't even matter.
Nah.
I gotta get the beat.
What's a good beat? Hold on. Let's see.
You better pick something good, or I'm gonna be mad at you, bro.
I might do R&B-ish. I might do. Which one? Do you want hip hop or do you want R&B?
I want something with a damn drum, homie. Play it. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
I want you to cut the cake. I don't even want to rap it right now, man.
We gonna come on
I
now.
We got some cake and ice cream. That's all I came for. You know what I'm saying?
You gonna get it. We gonna get it.
I'm just gonna let you pick something because I don't know.
Let's do it.
Is it instrumental? What is this? Yo, check it out.
Yo, Cool J.
Cause I ain't never had a bad day in my life, and I know two wrongs don't make it right, but it sure does make it nice and even. So I'ma stay positive and keep believing.
Yeah, that was kind of like, yeah, LL Cool J. Come on.
It's okay, but
the beat, you want another beat?
That's kind of.
You want another beat? Let's do it.
That's more commercial. That ain't too hip hop-y right now. You're gonna keep picking beats for me all day. I'm picky, bro.
Heavy G. Alright. Let's see if you can do something to this.
Classic, you know, something that everybody knows.
Everybody loves this. Everybody knows this one.
What?
I don't know. Is this gonna be a hard beat to rap to?
Does it even play?
Oh. You know this one?
Yeah. Whatever, here, you want me to freestyle something?
Freestyle something, then I'll do it.
Hey, yo, check it out, right here on killerradio.org. It's your main man, Ronan Gray. I'm on the corner of Beverly and Vermont. I just blow them all away, just leave them away and smoke. I ain't no joke. Now check it out, fools want to step, you know, they might get poked. I used to be a loke, fools want to look at me crazy. But I'm out here chilling, snatching up their babies. Mama, no looking for the drama. Who want to talk some trash, what's up? Don't be alarmed when a king like me steps in. Watch how I make it happen, yo, I'm still Ronan. Slashing like the samurai, sick with a sword. Damn, I've been doing my thing. Shout out to my boy, Fatal Mac B. He's chilling on my side. Bobby Buck, what's up, man? We keep it live. Happy birthday to Reverend Olu. You know what's up, dog. You know how we do. Can a mother stop my grind? Till the day I die. You know I got to shine. Yeah, everything's fine. I drink a lot of water. Avoid law and order. Because these fools be trying to catch me. Helicopters, choppers be trying to stress me. But I don't let them get me, G. I gotta be so smooth and slick. Old school rhymes like the dude Slick Rick. One patch over my eye, you know you can't stop the kid. Watch how violent I can get. On the microphone, I'm still an old beast. Who wanna talk trash, man? Ain't no peace. Yeah, but I just lie, cause it's all positive vibes. You know I keep it live when I rock the party, rock the crowd or the show. It's Ronan Gray, still representing Triple O. Oh.
Yo, I say I'm big on, I'm doing my thing constantly. What you say? Thank God I live to be 73, but 37. What I say is heaven. When what? I'm doing my thing, I'm doing back to Kevin.
What?
I'm big on and I like to do my flow. I like
Damn.
To do my thing. I like to go through the show because I'm wet. I'm tight. I'm all right. Number
what?
One, y'all. And I'm stepping in the sight.
Get
when
it.
I step in the right, I got G-O-D. That's what I'm saying. God is with me. Can't nobody touch me when I'm doing it right. I'm doing it tight. Hey, God bless me because I'm all right. Hey, come on, Mac, do
yo,
something. Do something.
Mac B, you want to get
yo,
on a
yo,
mic tonight.
Come on, brother. Come on. Come on, brother. Come on, brother. Come on. Come on, brother. Come on, brother. Come
yo.
On. Come on, brother. Huh. Come
hey,
on,
yo,
brother.
Hey,
I got number love for you.
I'm from the city of angels till I die. And watch out, man. You know I always keep it live. People checking me, looking at me crazy. But it don't ever stop me. I'm still amazing. Like Spider-Man, jump from building to building. Like Superman, I could catch them all in one swift leap. I'm one of those dudes, baby, I'm not a creep. But my house, you might want to come over and sleep in between the sheets. Oh, keep them nice and fresh together. Yo, it's whatever because I'm still putting it down for three letters. Oh, check me. R-O-N-I-N-G-R-A-Y. Yeah, homie.
You know what? We're going to switch up the beat real quick. We're going to switch up the beat. Let's see if you
that
know this.
That was okay right there,
yeah,
man.
We're
going to
switch
on,
up
man.
The beat. Let's switch
you
up the beat.
You want LL Cool J, man. All right. That's how
remember
I
this?
Get.
Remember this?
I'll
hey! Hey, yeah, let's do it. Hey,
you
want to hey,
it off?
Hey, get it up. Hey, I'm classic, like the style, like a mile. I be running and I'm running it like the foul, cause I'm doing what? I'm big old, you feel me? What? You know, you can't kill me, cause as long as I got my back, what you saying? God is all that. Hey, I ain't the best, but hey, I'm the best in the north, south, and west, cause
yeah.
I got G-O-D and J-E-S-U-S is the best. Jesus Christ is what? That's the test. I'm blessed and I'm doing it better than you ever could. Hey, hey, it's all to the good. Cause 3-7. Hey. Ooh, yeah, yeah.
I feel like I gotta do something.
Hey, you gotta do something quick.
Damn.
Oh,
check it out.
Yeah. Get it, get it.
I was cruising down Beverly Boulevard in my car. I seen this chick just chilling at the bus stop. So I pulled down my window like, what's up? You wanna hop in the ride and take a slide with me? Maybe we could go chill at the beach, ride some bikes and maybe just catch a drink. I don't know, but she was looking so damn fly. Big boobies, big booty, nice shaped thighs. Yo, I had to get her. She jumped out my ride and I didn't get a number. Oh, yo, but I was just chilling. I'm confused right now, but whatever.
That's enough. That was cool. We did our thing. I wanted you to do it, but we'll do it next time.
But you know that.
Okay.
You know, okay. The important thing about freestyling is always just to have fun, though. You know what I'm saying? It's not always about kicking something that's memorized or whatever.
Yeah.
But it's the opportunity for the artist to improvise, you know what I'm saying? To see what you can produce on the spot.
You better
say that. That's all it is. It's just about having fun. So you don't got to be super like,
you gotta be
I'm
super
not Eminem, and, you know what I'm
saying? Yeah. But we're going to get into your song, Dan. All
right, let's get into my record.
R-O-N-I-N. This is, you know what? This is my favorite record by him.
You can find it now on Amazon, Google Play, Apple Music. If you don't want to pay, you could stream it live on Spotify.
I like that.
Just search Ronan Gray.
I've always told him, when I first heard this record, this was always one of my favorite songs because this is one of my favorites.
And it's my birthday.
And there's a music video on YouTube, too.
Yep, on YouTube.
Yeah.
Ronan Gray, self-titled.
Yeah. And so now, my favorite song on my birthday. Let's get into it.
Ronan Gray. Happy birthday.
Yeah, that was the awesome Ronan Gray with the freestyle. We just did it, you know. I had to kick a little bit, you know. I'm not a rapper, but I still had to kick it a little bit. I still had to do a little rapping, and, you know, that was one of my favorite episodes. And right now, what Mac B is doing, he has his own podcast. He's also doing refereeing for the NFL. I almost said NBA, but he's doing the NFL. And Ronan, I'm so proud of this brother. He's still doing good, still doing music. He also got accepted to the Theater of Dramatic Arts program in a really prestigious school, and I'm very, very proud of him. But you guys, we're going to play my very favorite song by him. This song is called Ronan Gray, R-O-N-I-N Gray. Let's get into it on the 250th episode of Big Ol' Top 20 Countdown, Part 2, baby.
R-O-N-I-N, what's his name? He's spitting flames like G-R-A-Y. It's wise to not look in his eyes, cause Ronan Gray is revived. R-O-N-I-N, what's his name? He run the game like G-R-A-Y. He's thrived till the day that he died, cause Ronan Gray is alive. The return of the Red Dragon, never lagging. You know I come through, yeah, you know I'm always bagging. Keep them wrapped up, nickels and dimes. You know I'm never wasting time, cause I gotta get mine. I'm about to pave the way for a lot of my dudes been doing it right in history. You're tired of being a slave, you wanna own your own? This is how we do it, congregate to take the throne. And if they don't give it, we gonna go to war. These are my terms, faces on the floor. This is my life from the gutter, gotta get the best. Royal Heights, chosen people, yeah, we all blessed. Still I rise, check my eyes, attracting women all different walks of life. You know I'm never letting go, like the Spanish conquer Mexico. I'm chasing for the weight of gold. I'm R-O-N-I-N, what's his name? He's spitting flames like G-R-A-Y. It's wise to not look in his eyes, cause Ronan Gray is revived. R-O-N-I-N, what's his name? He run the game like G-R-A-Y. He's thrived till the day that he died, cause Ronan Gray is alive. Can you keep up? Do you pay the bills? With the rapping that you're doing, man, I got skills. Don't cut your slack, they wanna talk smack, cause the way you wear your pants and your hat, don't give them none of that. I come through, run them over like a train. The organization that I'm building just can't be explained. Insane in the brain, yeah, a little loose. Half the hood work the system, squeeze them out of juice. And can't nobody slow the kid Ronan Gray. Built the empire, 30 years we here to stay. We lined up with the angel kings crossing the threshold. Watch yourself, man, and yeah, you know I am. Riding with the
the click, pull my soul out in the hit. We here to rule the land, I got him with the left hand. Understand, I conquer it because I'm R-O-N-I-N. What's his name? He's spitting flames like G-R-A-Y. It's wise to not look in his eyes, cause Ronnie Gray is revived. R-O-N-I-N. What's his name? He run the game like G-R-A-Y. He's thrived till the day that he
check
died.
It out, Ronnie Gray is alive.
When the spirit of God enters the room, you watch Ronnie Gray rise about the tomb. Make way for the greatest. Yeah, I know a lot of dudes hate this. I come through stomping them down, breaking them up, letting them know I'm taking over your town. Don't frown, don't be sad. Bastard sons, I've come to be your dad. I'm just letting y'all know how we setting up shop. Come join Triple O. Ain't nothing stop my flow. Some bullets have names, y'all know how that goes. I'm done playing, breaking rules, finna school these mules, how I duels with the tools. Your dude shooting for a long shot, thinking that you're hot. I got news, you're not.
R-O-N-I-N. What's his name? He's spitting flames like G-R-A-Y. It's wise to not look in his eyes, cause when he craves revive. R-O-N-I-N. What's his name? He run the game like G-R-A-Y. He's thrived till the day that he died, cause when he craves alive.
Also, too, we want to say happy early birthday to Ronan Gray. He's going to be the big 4-0 on the 30th. Happy early birthday, brother, to you, man. Also, you guys, let's get back into this countdown. My number 7 favorite guest, they were on my show, I think it was the second or third season. Oh, I love them both. They're fantastic. Suwan Weaver and Sarah Lightman. They were just, man, I had such a great time, and Suwan is so funny. Sarah is just a really great spirit. But you guys, let's get into their episode. This is a snippet of their little episode, the number 8, Sarah, Suwan Weaver and Sarah Lightman on Big Ooh's Top 20 Countdown 250th Edition Part 2, baby. Yeah, y'all, that was the number 19 song, Killer. Featuring Drake, my cousin Nipsey Hussle. We're doing a tribute to him this week. We also have two of our guests, Sarah and
Suwan Weaver.
Suwan, yeah. Yeah, you guys, how you all doing?
I'm good.
Doing so good.
That's
you.
Woo!
Doing great.
We're having a party up
in here. Yeah, we're having a party up in here. We're having a great time. Ah, so Sarah.
Yes.
What's going on with you? What's going on with your music?
There's a lot going on. I'm in a music contest. The drawing of the winner is next Friday the 12th.
Oh, okay.
So it's called the Music Cash Contest, and it's a brand new kind of a music contest where you just have to rack up votes. So it's kind of like, you know, if you want to win a lottery, you put more tickets in.
Oh,
so
okay.
It's kind of, well, but it's like not like that where you just get it's kind of like a popularity contest. But,
okay.
But yeah, so you try to get as many votes as possible.
Okay.
Everybody can vote one time for free.
Okay.
And then you can get your friends to vote and everything. So that's kind of like my short term thing that I'm working on. And why I'm doing it is I don't know if you've heard about Pledge Music, but Pledge Music hasn't paid many of their artists, and I'm one of them. So,
oh, wow.
So I raised, some grand money to get my album done, and because I haven't been paid, I've been paying out of pocket. So I've been finding different ways to go around it until we have it sorted out with a lawyer.
Okay.
So this is one of the ways, one of my little odd ways of... So if anybody wants to vote, it's just musiccash.com, only one C. If you go to my Instagram at Sarah Lightman, Sarah with an H, Lightman,
okay.
And man is one word.
Okay.
On my Instagram, or search for me on Facebook, the link is all over my post. It's all over my profile. And you just log in and vote. Super simple. I'll send you the link after.
Okay.
So that's what I'm working on. The album is kind of focused on... I moved to LA blindly, and
okay.
It was really terrifying.
Okay.
I used to do acting, so I was doing acting during that, and then I fell back into my love of music after I moved out here, which
is
crazy. So And I grew up in a musical family. So,
oh, wow.
So the album is kind of circulated around my experiences. And my dad passed away when I was really young. So
oh, sorry he was. To hear
that's
that.
Okay. He was also a. Yeah, we have a lot of death in the room, but it's okay.
Oh, wow.
So my dad was a singer-songwriter. So it was kind of scary after that. Like, how do you continue doing music
yes.
when, like, your heroes, like,
gone?
Gone
yeah.
when you're so young. So after I found my way back into it, I ended up realizing that my experiences of what I learned from him just naturally got carried into my music. So the album is sort of circulated around those two ideas. So I wow. want to release it by the summer. And then in lieu of that, I'm having a pre-release tour on
okay.
the East Coast.
Okay.
From New York, New Jersey, Philly, starting on the 21st of April. So it's coming up really soon.
Wow.
So
that's
there's
so
a lot
cool.
going on.
Yeah,
but
that
thanks.
Is so cool.
Yeah.
How long have you been doing music? You said you've been raised in a musical family, but how long
right.
have you personally been
personally
doing
Personally been really going for it.
Yeah.
I'd say like about almost three and a half years. So not
wow.
really a very long time.
Okay.
But I've just been like, you know, once I was like, no, I really want to do this. Then I was like, oh man, I got to grow and catch up with my growth, you know?
Yeah.
You're like, I'm behind my growth spurts. So,
you're right on time, man. You're right on time. I don't know how old
yeah.
you are, but I think you're just right on time because actually, to be honest with you,
yeah.
I don't like to put myself in interviews, but I'm gonna say it like this: I actually started doing music when I was like solo music when I was like 21.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. First single came out when I was 22, I'd really start super young. So I don't know how old you are, so you're probably right on track.
I'm a bit older, but
yeah, you're right on track. But you listen, my first album didn't come out until I was 26.
Wow.
Yeah, so
it took a little bit of time.
You're right. You're right on that. You're right on track. Sometimes it takes a long time, but it'll be worth it.
No, that's great. No, you make it about you. It's your show. I think that's fine.
Come on, y'all. Tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm a stand-up comic, and I've got a show this weekend on Saturday night at the Ice House, and then I've got another one coming up April 22nd at Sal's Secret Comedy Hole. My name's Suwan Weaver.
Yes.
That's what I do.
I actually saw them both at the Ice House a couple of weeks ago, I think it was, and I was like, you guys, I gotta have you guys on my show. And you guys, I don't know, it divine timing, you know. It's always divine timing.
Just
you guys
out.
Just yeah man. I was like, dang, Suwan was very, very funny. I just enjoyed her stand-up.
Aww.
I was like, this woman, to me, she's a legend in comedy. I said, I got my first bona fide superstar on the show.
I'm a legend, folks. Let's just wear that on my sleeve. I'm a legend. I don't think I got legend status yet, not really, but sure, yes, let's lead up to it.
What made you start doing comedy?
You know, I think when you grow up with, like, troubled childhood, and not that it was that troubled,
uh-huh.
you know, it was more about really stuff in my head that didn't get expressed. And I think, you know, you just start making sarcastic jokes or whatever kind of jokes, and eventually comedy was a way to express myself and
yes.
figure out like deeper parts of myself that I wasn't letting out,
yeah,
you know, so, yeah. Yeah, like I really started like 8 years ago, and then I stopped.
Oh.
I started doing stand-up about 8 years ago, and
yeah.
I, you know, I'd go out to clubs and like really like how many shit stain things do I need to hear about? How many
yeah.
jokes about dudes and their stuff do I need to, like, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah,
I know exactly what you mean.
I
was like, I was too sweet or too innocent or whatever, and
yeah.
it just was overwhelming. So I
yeah.
stopped, and then I've just been back at it now for like a year, like less
oh,
than a year.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So, but you know what? I've done improv. I've been taking acting and performance and stuff like for 10 years.
Yeah.
So I think it all makes sense, like it's leading up to this.
Yeah.
And then like stand up, you know, like I liked all the old school guys like Bill Hicks and Joan Rivers and yeah. Don Rickles. Like, that's who I grew up watching.
Yeah.
You know, so, like, my parents were old. Yeah. And I'm old, too. Yeah. But my parents are really old.
You're not that old.
No, it's fine. I don't care. That's great. No, being old is good. I prefer it.
Yeah.
It's much better than when I was younger.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah. Yeah, I'll be honest with you, yeah. being young is a mess.
I was a mess, and let's just admit that. It's fine. But now I'm not, so now you know, now I can get out there.
That is awesome, y'all. That is so. We're going to talk more to these two wonderful women, ladies, whatever they want to call themselves.
Ladies, you know? Women, whatever, yeah. I identify as she, her.
She, her. All right, now. Right. Okay. We're going to talk more about your stand-up after this. Come on now. Let's get back into the countdown. You guys, I'm telling you, but that interview with Suwon, and I'll just give you guys a snippet of it. Well, the interview with Suwon and Sarah Lightman. Oh, Suwon Weaver and Sarah Lightman, those are just my favorite. I'm telling you, that is one of my favorite interviews that I ever did. I'm telling you, this show is, wow, I've had some really great episodes, but that's still one of my favorites. Suwon, she's still doing stand-up, but she's doing a lot. She's one of the most famous people in stand-up right now. And Sarah, she's doing music, still doing music. Matter of fact, we're going to get to one of her latest singles. This song is called Silence Live. Let's get into it. Silence Live, from the Nashville Songwriter Sessions on Big Ol's Top 20 250th Episode Part 2, baby. Yeah, y'all, that was the awesome Sarah Lightman
with Silence live from the Nashville Songwriter Sessions. Wow, that was so freaking awesome. But you guys, we're going to take a break from the countdown a little bit, and we're going to play one of my songs. This song is actually going to be released very, very soon. This song is called Too Many Bottoms in L.A. This is actually the second extra song of the week, the second extra song for this week. This is Too Many Bottoms in L.A. Let's get into it. I'll be cool. Top 20 countdown.
Welcome to L.A., land of misunderstanding, land of misfits. Yeah, I'm explaining it like this. Arriving the scene in L.A., I think it's all right, but no, baby, it ain't okay. Sex, drugs, and rock and roll, that's the thing. I'm looking for somebody, but all I find is a queen. Love, that's not right. Baby, it ain't tight. Give me one night. Give me your life. Oh, I'm just so frustrated. I just wanna go to a top. 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 You take me there. I just wanna go to a top. 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 Lipstick, soul stick. Try to put me on a dress, but it doesn't fit. Try to put me on some makeup, but it doesn't come out the way it comes out. Digging the scene, but I'm a misfit. Trying to find my way in a lost, crazy world. I'm lost in this frost. Don't know where to go. Maybe on the internet. Maybe in a chat room. Social media. Maybe at my job. Maybe around my friends. I gotta get out of this club. I just wanna go to a top. Yeah. I just wanna go to a top. Can you help me? I just wanna go to a top. I just wanna go to a top. Can you help me, baby? I just wanna go to a top. 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 Yeah. Can you help me? Can you get me out of this crazy, crazy labyrinth they call LA? I just wanna go to a top. Help me find my way. Yeah,
y'all, that's my single that's coming out very, very soon. That song is called Too Many Bottoms in L.A. And, yo, am I for right about that. But you guys, we're counting. This is part two of our 250th episode countdown. I'm telling you, I've had such a great time compiling all these artists together for this particular show. Oh, my God, I've had such a great time. And you guys, we're up to the number six position. Number six position is actually a tie. It's Brandon West and Stephen Folds. Both of them are just my absolute favorite guest. But you guys, let's get into it. Brandon West and Stephen Folds on Big Ooh, Stop 2250th episode.
Yeah, y'all. We're back with my guest, B. West. What's up with you, brother?
Hey, what's good? How you doing? Thanks for having me today.
Man, it's awesome to have you, brother. What's going on with you, brother? Tell my listeners about you.
Oh, man. Well, you know, my name is Brandon West. I'm a hip-hop artist out of Los Angeles, California. Been doing this rap thing for a minute. I more lean towards telling stories about my life, expressing what it is I think and feel in my music, you know, more along the lines of like J. Cole or a Kendrick style. And yeah, man, just here to have a little bit of fun today.
Yeah, man. So what's your latest, do you have a latest project that you're doing or anything? What's going on with you?
Yeah, man, my latest project is called Because I Like to Rap. And so basically it's just a compilation of a bunch of different songs from different topics. But the whole point in the album is to just express a bunch of different styles of rap instead of being locked into one or two styles for the entire record, you know. So really just having fun with rap itself and all of the different ways that it can be flexed out, you know, over different types of beats.
What made you, what inspired you to go to this level of music?
Well, it just seems like today people feel like they need to rap a certain way in order to be, you know, quote unquote hot, you know. And for me, I just love rap. So I was like, man, I'm going to just do an album where it's just straight up. I like to rap, you know, because I like to rap. And I'm not going to lock myself into a box as far as, like, what style I can rap in. Because, yeah. like, for me, my voice is more like an instrument.
Yeah.
More than just me, you know, talking talking loud over a beat, right? So I like to be able to stretch and flex my voice however I want. And I as Jay-Z said, I write to the beat.
Yeah.
So, you know, wherever the beat takes me is the way that I'm going to structure my flow. So that's what I mean by not being locked into a specific style. So I'm not going to do just trap songs because I'm not going to use just trap beats. You know, I'll use more New York hip hop style beats, some Dirty South beats, some West Coast style beats, you know, and then just let the beat tell me what to say. So then that's where the subject matter and the content comes from. So,
who are some of your influences?
Probably number one influence, my favorite artist is Andre 3000, you know, from Outkast, if we're talking about like rap influences. And also groups like The Far Side and which they were from LA, from Westchester, you know, back in like, you know, the 90s and whatnot. They're really dope. Wu-Tang, The Fugees, definitely The Fugees as well. All of them, especially Wyclef and Lauryn Hill, but all of them all together, just their flow is ridiculous, you know. So really just rootsy hip-hop artists, you know. And I love like some gangster rappers too. I really loved Ice Cube. I really still love Ice Cube's music, even the music he puts out today. As far as New York goes, man, I really love Redman. That was definitely one of my influences. Eminem made me not want to rap for a while because he just, when he first came out, because he was just like mind-blowingly devastatingly good, you know. So I mean, those type of rappers that really push the envelope for style matched with charisma and like lyrical content, whether that's just like Eminem being way out there and outlandish with what he says, or whether it's like Ice Cube, who's more lyrically about social issues that go on. You know what I'm saying? So regardless, just like really extraordinary artists.
Man, that's tight. To my listeners, I met him over at the open mic. Was it this month or was it last month?
Last month.
I met you at the open mic, and I was like, you know, we became like brothers, like friends, man. It's like, I was like, you know what? Even before I heard him rap, I said, you know what? I want him on my show. Also, he filmed part of my video, Until the Real Thing Comes Along, man. You're part of my video. He's a cool
on the
cat.
Fly.
Humble cat. You guys will learn a little bit more about him when we come back. So you guys, let's get back into this Prince tribute. Right at you, man. Tell us a little bit more about yourself and about your career and what you do. Because also, you said you're into Thai boxing, is that correct?
Yeah, man. I'm also a Muay Thai fighter. I have my first fight coming up on May 12th.
Okay.
I don't have the venue, so I can't tell you where it's at. But keep up with me on Instagram at West9000, that's WEST and the number 9000. If you want to get posted on with the wins and wears of my fight, also keeping up with me on this project that I'm working on. So basically this because I like to rap project that I'm working on right now, the album is done as far as being recorded. So what I'm working on now is video content. And so yeah, once the video content's out, I'm gonna put the record out on all the major forums, and also I'm mostly gonna try to sell it through my own website, because you know, why let other companies get a piece of what they didn't help me create, you know?
True.
So, you know, my suggestion to artists who have a following is eventually funnel people to your own website so you reap 100% of the benefit of what you sow, you know?
What's your take on the music industry right now? We were talking a little bit about it before, but
Give us a little bit of what your take is, like a 2-minute version.
Well, I mean, as far as like what? As far as the quality of music?
Yeah, the quality of music, and we were just talking about selfies and stuff like that and all that stuff. Okay. And tell us about it.
Well, man, you know, I think as far as the industry goes, as far as artists, it's kind of like an anybody can do it kind of industry now. So it definitely dampens the quality of music that you have access to. And I think that record labels, people said, you know, oh, record labels are dead and all of this. But I think that what record labels have managed to do is weasel their way into buying, kind of like creating artists with the money that they have. So, you know, there are people that professionally create memes for record labels, and basically they have the power to make whoever popular they want to make popular, right? And it actually costs them a hell of a lot less money than it used to cost them for doing what they used to call A&R, which is artists and repertoire for labels, right? Because, you know, social media costs virtually pennies on the dollar when it comes down to marketing, especially when you already have millions or billions of dollars to market, you know, anyway, right?
Yeah.
So I think that as far as the industry goes, the major industry, they pick and choose who they want to make popular, which is why even more so than ever, the radio is flooded with like the same 5 or 6 artists.
That's true.
Right? Because it's an investment. So, you want to this big of a payoff on your investment, promotion is everything. No better promotion still than the radio, because the radio is word of mouth.
That's true.
Right?
That's true.
So, I mean, there's that. And then there's sponsorships and shit, you know. So my suggestion to artists who already have a following is you already have the sponsors knocking at your door. You know, just make sure you got lawyers to look over the contracts of your sponsorships and just keep doing it yourself, you know, or do what LeBron did and hire on, you know, his friends and his family who are qualified to do the job instead of outsourcing to these major labels. Because at the end of the day, a label is like a colonist. They want to like ultimately acquire as much of what you make, you know, as possible. No matter how friendly the deal seems to be on the front end, you know. So, ultimately, as far as quality of music, yeah. I mean, I think that when anybody can do something, you know, it automatically that's an art, you know. Just because like it's push button technology, yeah. I think that it dampens the quality of the music.
You're right. Wow.
We got First United Methodist, L.A. First United Methodist in the house. We got the first man, Mr. Right. Steven. What's up, brother?
All right. Nothing much, man. It's just a Friday night in L.A.
Just a Friday night in L.A. You're getting holy on them, aren't you? Hey, yeah.
Absolutely.
Talk to us, brother. How are you doing?
Oh, I'm doing good. I'm doing really well. It's been I got to see my daughter last week.
That's awesome.
She's just turned 13, so
I got to spend
some time with her, and that was really good. Terrible 13s. Oh, no. But we had some good, kind of adult conversations that we hadn't had when she was younger. But it's all good. Really good. And what else are
you doing?
Oh, let's see. Well, working on some new music with the band. You know, okay. Diego just moved over into the Parsonage, and I'm looking at doing that.
Okay.
So we're going to start writing some more original stuff. We did that one song with you, which was your song.
All that.
And we have one at this moment. But we have some stuff coming up this week. Mandy recommended. She wanted to hear this song called Wave of Sorrow, which is an old U2 song. Yeah. It's off the Joshua Tree, but it was a cut that wasn't, I don't know if it was on the first recording or not. I don't think so. But it's pretty heavy, so we're going to tackle that. She's talking about being blessed this week. Blessed are you, so blessed are the poor in spirit, for they shall inherit the earth. But Bono has his own kind of beatitudes. That's what she's going to be talking about. And doing some, just a lot of auditioning, things like that. But
what?
Yep. But
so
you know how
that goes. So give us your official title of at the church. First of all, not only are you the first man, but give us your official title.
I'm just creative director. I mean, that covers music director and anything creative. We go through my filters, but in conjunction with Mandy, of course, just to kind of get ideas, because I've been doing it for about 10 years now.
Okay.
And I think I got a handle on things, and it's nice to get to experiment with something totally new and without walls, like I was saying before. you know, the tents just being up on Sunday morning.
How did you get hooked up with the church?
Well, I worked for Hollywood United Methodist Church for about 4 years, and I was married at the time, had my daughter, and I started doing music leading. They wanted me to experiment and start a new service because they said, we got to have a service for everybody who doesn't like the traditional stuff. So they said, you do it. And I said, okay. So I started doing that, ended up going to Texas, working in a church there for about 5 years, went through a divorce, got hired back for Hollywood United Methodist to open up another campus in Toluca Lake. I was there for 2 years, met Mandy, and we started talking about, you know, if we could have a place that we would want to go. Like, if we didn't know anything about church or about God or anything, where would we want to go? So we talked about it, and I came up with an idea called City Beautiful LA.
Okay.
And then before you know it, I got hired there just to kind of put together a worship service for that small group of people. Because they were going to close the church, that little group of people.
Oh, wow.
They were like, we were going to, you know, what do they call it? They were fallow, as they said, but they were going to end the church and give the money to someone else.
Oh, okay.
So Mandy got me hooked up with Jenny. I started leading like 30 minutes of worship. Then Mandy got appointed. Then we brought it outside because we were in a little room that wasn't real conducive to like community, which is that's how I met you, is because you were in the community walking by.
I was in the community. No, actually, my story was I was driving by to the movie theater, and I was like, oh, wow, I was involved in another church. I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to tell you what that is. We ain't gonna diss them. Anyways, and so I said, you know, I wanted to, like, get to a place, you know, right by my house. So I said, okay, cool, let me try this. Mm. And so, you know, I came, I think, the day before my birthday.
Yeah.
I remember that was the first time. And then I joined in July.
Yes, you did.
Yeah. I think. Look at me. We ain't gonna get like hallelujah. We ain't gonna fall out. We ain't gonna trust our engineers. Our engineers like, oh my God. But no, we ain't gonna get holy on you. We ain't gonna start speaking in tongues.
No.
Cha-la-la-la-la-la-la.
I don't know how to do.
Gonna do all that. I know how. You know, I'm an old. What you call old school Christian?
Yes,
you know what I'm saying? Pentecostal, what's it called? Church of God in Christian, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man, because I remember the first time I saw that. But anyways, we're not going to go. This is not about me. We got to get back into this count. Yeah, that was the number 15 song. Let me pull it up. I got sorry. I don't even know. That was Kanye West. I'm sorry. See, I gotta have my engineer help me because I sit up here off the air. We were sitting up here talking, having a good time, and like I accidentally clicked off the dang list. I'm like, you guys, that's why you should never talk and do a show at the same time, because you will like you will do so, you will mess up, you guys.
Yeah.
But you guys, we're sitting up here talking to Steven.
Yes, sir.
And he's the first, I call him.
I don't know where that started.
The first man. The first man of the church. Mm-hmm. Because our pastor, Mandy, she's a female. And so he's her. Shout out to Mandy. Shout out to LA First United. We love y'all. We love y'all. We love y'all. And don't get mad at me, Mandy. Don't say I can't preach no more because she
you did it while I was out.
Yeah. Don't say I can't preach no more. Oh, please forgive me. Don't make me go over there and bow down to you. Lord.
No.
Please, Mandy, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I have sinned against you.
It was good, man. I heard it was great.
Yeah, it was great. You weren't there. You missed it.
Mm.
I almost did the shouting thing, but I was feeling kind of like under the weather.
You needed me there.
But yeah, well, you should see me when I get into it. Ooh, you're gonna have to run for the hills. You'll be like, hallelujah! You know what I'm saying? You'll be like, yeah! You're having people falling out. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, Steven.
Yes, sir. What's up?
Brother. You said you also were doing acting too. Give me a little bit. Give me information about that.
Let's see. Well, I signed with Avant Artists this past, I guess it was the end of the summer. And so they're repping me, and I'm enjoying getting out there a lot, doing some commercials, and hoping to get into theatrical this spring.
Okay.
But it's good. And I think the whole just going to auditions and having a great time and leaving and feeling on top of the world is what it's about. So the job there for me is auditioning and just, you know, being myself, man, connecting with people.
Yeah, being yourself and connect with people.
Mm-hmm.
That's freaking awesome, man. Mm-hmm. You connect with people. How long have you been doing the acting?
Just since, God, maybe just a year ago. I was with a different agent, but that's a long story. Anyway, so a little bit over a year now.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yeah, coming out a little bit later. And
How'd you get into the field of acting?
How did I get into it? Oh, that's a good question. I did a director, and this is way back in college, asked me if I wanted to audition for the role of John Wilkes Booth for Assassins. There's this musical called Assassins.
Okay.
And it's pretty intense. It's funny, but it's also I don't know. It's a great play, and I looked at the script and talked to him and listened to some of the music, and I was in. So at that point, I got bitten by the acting bug, but I had a lot of other stuff to do, some shit to deal with. I mean, you know what I mean. Years of, can I say that? Okay. Well,
Lord, forgive him. We're gonna say a prayer right now. Right, Lord, sorry. This is supposed to be a holy show, and he's saying the SHIT word. Lord, holy. He's the first. Lord, if he's the first husband, Lord, we forgive him. Husband, but the first man. Lord, forgive him. Lord, let's call him down. Let's call the Lord. Shalala, hala, 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 hala.
Amen. See, look, yeah, I'm healed. See,
look,
sorry
about
that.
Look, the engineer's looking at me like, what the hell are you doing? You know what I'm saying? Yeah. See, look, now you got me cussing, see?
No.
See, you're a bad influence, brother.
No,
see, hold on.
I was a bad influence.
Got me cussing. See, y'all was in the... Anyways, go ahead.
I went down a long path.
Do your thing. Do your
thing. A long
thing.
Path of darkness.
Do your thing, brother.
Many,
you know
many
what?
Years.
I'm going to sit up here and try to heal myself while you're talking.
Yeah,
this is a mess.
So, just went through a lot of hard times. I won't go into it. I was living in Florida at the time. That's where I grew up. But so I went through a very long, dark season and came up out of it and, you know, got married and had my daughter. And then things changed. And so I think the great thing that I believe about the divine is that there's a huge plan and it is never too late to do anything. And if it's in your heart and it's put in your heart at a young age or at any age, you know it when you feel it, and you just need to follow it. You know, it's not about the end game, but it's about just all of it. As trite as that sounds, you know, that's about true. The journey, it's just enjoying the process, I think. And so I'm glad I wouldn't be sitting here with you if I wouldn't have let that happen and
that's true.
Be guided by the Spirit.
That's
you know?
True.
So,
that's
anyway.
True. Speaking of being guided, we're going to the second extra song of the week, which is my song.
All right.
It's called Love is Love. We filmed the video this past. Hold on. Not yet, not yet. Hold on. Don't start it. Yeah, I'm giving the background of the day. So, come on. We filmed the video this past, what's it called? This past Saturday. And it's crazy because I posted a picture of me and, because I was supposed to be getting married in the video. Everybody thought, oh, congratulations. But no, I'm not married yet. No, it's not happening yet. But you guys, let's get into the second extra song of the week. My song. Love is love. On Big Ol's Top 20.
No matter where you go.
Yeah, you guys, we had to play a little bit of Steven and Brandon's episode. They're both tied at number 6. You guys, I'm telling you, those shows were the best. I think Brandon has been on the show. He was just on our Thanksgiving show this past Thanksgiving. I want to say shout out to him like 2 or 3 months ago. Shout out to him. And shout out to, he was supposed to fight that night on, at the fighter's rep, but unfortunately he injured himself, but hopefully he'll be back doing the fighting in March, and we're also waiting for new music from him. And Steven, he's no longer the first man, him and Mandy broke up, but he is getting married again, hopefully in September, so, and he's still at the church, and we still work together. As a matter of fact, we taped this next song at the church of LA First United Methodist Church. This is from my live album, Live Through the Years. This song was called Pray For Me, and it features El Dorado 1853. Let's get into it. And then after that, we're going to play one of Brandon's old songs. Let's get into it on Big Ol's Top 20 Countdown, 250th episode, part 2.
Yeah, I want to thank Olu Shea for suggesting this song, and he's going to sing it with us.
Oh, gosh. Okay.
I don't know, man. I like the other lab, but this one right here, man, this one feels like home. Maybe it's just because this is where I came first. I'm in the building with my man Gilbert. What up? Hey. Hey, I dedicate this song right here to my homeboy DJ, man. One day we was sitting in the car, man, and we was just bumping this beat right here. And he's like, man, I don't rap, man, but if I ever did rap, man, I would do this song where I go like, yeah, bet you didn't know, 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 bet you didn't know. So I was like, all right, man, I was like, look, man, for this next album I do, man, I'ma go ahead and drop that shit for you, man. And then I ended up coming up with something a little like this. Bet you didn't know that I'm official. Sitting at the table with the gold getters. Gold glisten all on my neck. I be hitting all my goals, nigga. Bet you didn't know that my heart turned cold since my last girlfriend, man. I'm numb on hoes. Bet you didn't know that the good die young. Better be a bad boy if you wanna get some. Bet you didn't know that the world don't care if your mama die young and your daddy ain't there. Bet you didn't know that the world don't give no fucks, even though the world know it ain't fair. Bet you didn't know I ain't got no hope, just a whole lot of love for the black folk. Bet you didn't know that I'm mean that. I'ma hate you cause you can't be black, no. Bet you didn't know that the world's so fucked cause stupid motherfuckers can't see that. Talk the world to haters cause we black. They try to tell a nigga just relax, but I'm just waving from the home of the misbehaving. Built on the backs of the stolen slave men. Taught the cavemen to not be cavemen. In return they turn their backs and slave them. Beat them, rape them, sure they're free, but you are free to hate them. We'll poison them when we inoculate them. Impoverish them and then incarcerate them. We'll make it hard for them to hold a job. Still the very women that they love. They'll flock to us, we got the bucks. They all now shallow enough, they whole culture is who? Us.
Damn.
Bet you didn't know you was whitewashed. Sucking on the dick of your white boss. Sleeping on the game like night talk. Bet you didn't know I was right, y'all. Bet you didn't know I was right, y'all. Sucking on the dick of your white boss. Sleeping on the game like night talk. Bet. Real talk, man. I be trying to tell these cats out here, man, like, it's okay, go get your money, man, but don't be no slave, man. Don't sell your soul, man. They ain't trying to hear it, though, man. These niggas,
man,
they do whatever for money, man.
Bet you didn't know me. 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 Bet you didn't know. Bet you didn't know me.
I bet.
Bet you didn't know.
I bet.
Bet you didn't know.
Even if you did, I don't give a shit. Sipping on lean till I'm feeling it. Killing my innocence. Ain't about money, what we doing in. I don't do friends, count new hundreds in a new BM. Niggas wanna see him, but they gotta wear shades. Man, I shine like the sun in the middle of the day. Bet you didn't know I'm the motherfucking way. Better wear a life jacket if you wanna be safe. Bet you didn't know I got a trunk full of bass and a brain full of thoughts that can never be replaced. $1 billion dreams like a young Billy Gates. Better light up the scene when I step in the place. Bet you didn't know that my fashion's a dime. Fine like wine, I'm better with time. This asterisk describes my frame of mind. Dr. Jekyll, this is Mr. Hyde. Apocalyptic, cataclysmic mind. Crazy cause I'm crazy by design. Bet you didn't know I hate the world. The fakeness of it makes me want to earn. Grown ass men to act like little girls. Bragging about they diamonds and they pearls. No credit, no receipts, no referrals. Middle fingers up, fuck the world. Bet
that.
Hey, yeah, man, I can't never be no slave, man. I'm telling you like that right now, man. I gotta do me, and I gotta do it the way I wanna do it.
Bet you didn't know me. 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 Bet you didn't know me.
I bet.
Bet you didn't know me.
I bet.
Bet you didn't know me.
Y'all, that was one of the tracks from the number six artist that we did a tie. We did Pray For Me. That was we just did Pray For Me. We also did played their thing. That song was called Bet You Didn't Know by Brandon. It's one of his old songs. I really like that one. But y'all, it's time to get into the number five artist. Her name is Judy B. She's the head at Judy Barksdale. She's the head of the Gospel Southern California Gospel Music Award, Southern California Gospel Music Awards. and we did an interview with her. She, matter of fact, she thinks she was on the 75th show. Yeah, the 75th or the 80th show. And this is a snippet from it. So you guys, let's play her. That's number 5, Judy Barkstone on Big Ooh's Top 20, 250th episode countdown part 2, baby.
I gotta ask a question real quick. You don't mind. How did you get started with the Southern California Gospel Music Awards? Give us the background of it.
Okay, it started in 2015. The Lord just placed it on my heart because I deal with a lot of independent artists, and a lot of times they don't get the recognition that named celebrities get. So the Lord placed it on my heart to start that particular year. And what I did that year was I just prayed about certain people, and the Lord gave them to me, and I just put it out there that, hey, you were nominated, you know, come through. So we did a real big thing out at the Torrance Civic Center, mm-hmm. at the theater there. And we had, I believe it was 23 artists that we gave awards to.
Wow.
Yeah, 23 artists. The only thing that kind of disappointed me was that some of them were kind of skeptical mm-hmm. about it. You know, it was like, you know, well, who's putting this on? And, you know, why this and why that? And that kind of put a bad taste in my mouth, so to speak. And it was just kind of like, okay, wow, somebody's recognizing you, and then you question it, and then you have a problem with it, you know. But then God has to work on me too, just like he does everybody else. So the next year, I was just kind of like, Lord, I don't want to do that. If people are going to be that ungrateful, and I'm not saying everybody was, because there were a lot of people who reached out, didn't question it, just said thank you. You know, there's always that one, but I had more than one, which was made it good. But a lot of things were coming up that year, so by the time I was ready to do it, I just didn't have the time. And then last year, I had to have major surgery. So I was down for like 3 or 4 months, so I didn't get a chance to do it. So this year I was like, Lord, you gave it to me. Let me quit sitting on it and doing, you know, not doing what I'm supposed to do. I have a good team behind me. So let's just move forward. So I did, chose the date. And what happened was in 2000, when we did the first one, we put up where people could nominate, because after that I said, I want people to nominate. I don't want to choose. So we put the nominations out there. People sent their nominees' names in and everything. And it went on a website where the votes took place. I had nothing to do with it. It was like, have people vote for you, and we're going to leave it at that. So when it closed, we had all these names. We had all these persons who had been nominated and people who had voted. We had over almost 3,000 people who voted. And so I didn't want to start back doing it and then redoing what we had already done, because I thought it would be unfair to those persons who had been nominated for an event that should have happened 2 years ago. So my thing is, let's just pick up where we left off. Let's use those same nominees and those same votes. Some of the people are not necessarily doing those same things that they were nominated for at the time, but it is what it is, and we're moving forward. So we've allowed those same persons, you know, we've kept the list, we've kept the tally of the votes, the winners and all that, and so we're just moving forward from that point. So we're just looking forward to grow bigger and bigger, and then the opportunities of meeting all these new different artists. A lot of these artists I've never experienced being in any form with them to even know their music, but to know that somebody cared enough about them to vote, it was just like, I have to listen to this person. So I've been really blessed just by listening to a lot of these people's music. So I know that these aren't the only persons that are out there. There are a lot of others in Southern California that need to be recognized for what they do. Some people feel like, oh, I'm just singing from church to church, but that's a ministry and it needs to be recognized. And if people, you know that we're here and that we're doing it, they'll step up and say, well, you know, hey, I got a group in my church that sings. So that's where it started and that's where we are now.
Cool. You know what? Yeah, that's awesome. That's awesome. We're going to talk a little bit more to Judy.
You guys, wow, that just gave you guys just a little snippet of that awesome interview. That interview was so, so fantastic. She's a wonderful sister. She's awesome. But she's a manager of this next artist that we're going to be playing. His name is Marquise Williams, and this is one of his songs. The song's called Wave Your Hands. I don't know if I'm going to play the whole thing because he hasn't come on our show yet, but I don't know. It depends on how the spirit moves me. So let's get into it. Wave Your Hands by Marquise Williams, the artist of Judy Barksdale on Big Old Top 20 Countdown.
Your voice. do your dance. It's all right to dance. It's time to celebrate your victory. Come on.
For some reason that cut off, but it was a good song. But you guys, we're gonna take a break from this countdown, and it's time to just celebrate with Whitney Houston. You guys, it originally was gonna be an old school jam, but we've been playing the old school jam. But this is kind of a newer jam, but this came out like 10 years ago, so it's not an old jam yet. But we're just celebrating. We're celebrating 250th episode, part two. Let's get into it. Celebrate Whitney Houston and Jordan Sparks on Big Ol' Stop 250th episode.
Yeah, ooh. Do, ho, do, ho, ho, ooh. Oh, yeah. Well, everybody's been so uptight and forgetting to live the life. Let all the problems get them down till it makes you wanna shout. All the rain away, no more obstacles.
You celebrate me. It's time to celebrate. Yeah. Come on and celebrate. Yeah. I want to celebrate. Huh. I celebrate you. You celebrate me. Yeah. That was a, no, man. That was a, I got the third extra song of the week. I count that as third extra song of the week. I love it. Whitney Houston and Jordan Sparks with Celebrate. That was from the Sparkle soundtrack. But you guys, let's get back into the My Top 20 Artist Countdown. This is number four. We made it all the way up to number four. Number four is one of my absolute favorites. He taught me so much. We actually worked together at Accelerated Radio, where I got my start as Pastor O, 7-8 years ago almost. You guys, let's get into it. This is Brother Andy, and he made it to number four of our artist countdown on Big O's Top 20 Countdown.
And we're talking to my guest, Andy. What's going on, Andy?
Not much, man. Another day, another dollar, man. Just trying to live, man.
Oh, that's awesome, man. That's awesome, man. What's going on with you? Tell my listeners about yourself.
Oh, man, you know, radio host / board engineer / entrepreneur.
All right, now.
Yeah, man. So, you know, I've been involved with radio for over 15 years. Different type of capacity. So that's your boy right there.
Wow. How did you get into radio?
Oh, man. I really didn't have any a passion or a desire to pursue radio until I had a conversation with my sister, freshman year of college. I went to school trying to be a music producer, but I didn't necessarily know the term or what the program was, you know what I'm saying, to learn how to make music. I wanted to go to school to make beats. So I remember having a conversation with my sister, and we were just talking about, you know, goals and aspirations with regards to me being in college and me wanting to pursue music. And, you know, she was just like, why don't you intern at a radio station? And, you know, a light bulb popped up in my head, and I was like, wow, I never thought about that, never thought about it. So after that conversation, I remember going into my my department where I was technically majored at, you know, the music department. And they always had, like, a booklet of resources, you know, jobs and internships and stuff like that. And I remember just kind of flipping through the pages, and I saw an internship opportunity with 100.3 The Beat at the time.
Wow.
And I remember I applied, and the rest was history with that, you know. I ended up interviewing with them, and I was there for about 6 months. I was on the promotions department. So I was on the street team. I was riding in the van, a little Escalade. I couldn't drive because, you know, I was an intern.
Yeah.
But, you know, I worked with the likes of a Chuck Dizzle, who's on Real 92.3 right now.
Yeah.
And Neil Anderson, I believe she does.
Oh, yeah.
I believe she does work with Fox Soul, if I'm not mistaken.
Oh, wow.
With Chipmunk and stuff like that. So it was a fun experience. Outside of being out in the community doing work, also got the opportunity to do some office work, some admin work or whatnot. So I remember being able to release prizes to prize winners. So anybody who caught that contest, you know, if it was a cash prize or concert tickets, you know, I was the one to, you know, release that. So that was pretty cool. So that was kind of the genesis of my radio experience.
Wow, that is so cool, yeah, man.
All started just from a conversation from my sister.
Wow. So you can do anything, y'all. Y'all just like have the right conversations. And, like,
I mean, you also got to apply yourself as well, too.
That's true.
You know, I applied myself in doing that, too. So
that's true.
You know, the door's definitely open for me.
That's cool. That's cool. We're going to get talk more to our guests. And I'm begging y'all to keep on listening, y'all. We doing it B.I.G. here. And Andy.
Yes, sir.
How did you hook up with Kevin Nash?
Oh, after, I don't want to say after college. So during college, you know, I'm trying to find work. I'm trying to, you know, earn an income. At the time being, it just something like internships were coming my way. You know, outside of the 100.3 The Beat internship, I secured another internship with Power 106 / Movement 93.9. That was more administrative work. So I was in the traffic department. I was doing a lot of data entry. And essentially what I was doing was just basically kind of logging in all the ads that previously aired into our database system, just to kind of show that, you know, hey, this particular ad aired or whatnot. So I did a lot of that. And then I secured another internship with 90.7 KPFK,
okay,
which was a talk radio station. I got that internship through a couple of professors, actually one professor of mine that I took a class, a Pan-African Studies class. Shout out to Dr. Kimberly King. You know, at my time at Cal State LA, that's school that I attended, over the years, you know, I knew of her going to, you know, social events on campus, and she would always talk about how, you know, she hosted a show. And, you know, when I finally took her class, you know, I remember one day after class, I asked her and I inquired. I was like, hey, are you looking for interns? Are you looking for support or whatnot? And she was like, yeah, come along. So over there, I ended up being their line producer. And basically, I was just kind of just keeping them on track, you know, with radio. You know, a lot of the times outside of podcasting, you know, you're dealing with a clock.
Yes.
So this is terrestrial radio. So, you know, you got to make sure that, hey, if it's 5 minutes before a break, you got to inform the host, because, you know, when they're having a conversation and, you know, they're discussing what it is that they're discussing, you know, sometimes they're not paying attention, you know, to the clock. So that was me just keeping them, you know, on board with the time. And when callers were calling, I would screen the calls, make sure, you know, there's, you know, whoever's calling in, whatever question or comment you have, you know, you're on topic. So all of that experience led to me actually professionally working in the nonprofit sector.
Oh, wow.
What got me introduced to the nonprofit sector was this program called Public Allies. I secured that. You know, when I was at Cal State LA, I was doing a lot of community work, essentially. Being on campus, doing a lot of community work. I was part of the Black Student Association. I was their marketing guy. So that's when I kind of developed a desire and a passion to want to maybe, like, give back. So when the Public Allies program came about, I felt like it was perfect timing. So I got a lot of experience working in the nonprofit sector, working for various organizations. Man, I was a youth counselor. I was a case manager. I was an internal auditor. I was an executive assistant. So, you know, I had a lot of experience within that. So I was kind of unemployed after a while. And an opportunity came about to be an after-school program coordinator.
Okay.
Teaching kids how to do radio.
Wow.
So a couple, you know, former colleagues of mine reached out to me. And they was like, hey, you got the community experience. And, hey, you know, you're an intern at a whole bunch of these radio stations. Man, you'd be the perfect guy. And it just so happened to be that Kevin Nash was the instructor. So I ended up getting the job, and me and Kevin Nash, we basically worked together to teach kids at a particular high school how to basically conduct their own radio program. So we brought a lot of the equipment on the campus, and we taught kids how to research, how to, how to find their voice in radio, and it was a cool experience, you know what I'm saying? It was very valuable for youth, you know? I think a lot of, you know, I was kind of jealous of the kids because I was like, I wish we had a radio program.
Yeah.
I was in school and whatnot. So it was a little bit challenging kind of trying to draw the value, let these kids know how valuable this is. So that's how I connected with Kevin Nash. Really, Accelerate Radio started off as a program teaching kids how to do radio.
Yo, that was the number four artist, Andy Nielsen. I love him, man. Also, too, he was the one that persuaded me to release my single called God is Love, and it became a really big hit. I want to say thank you, Jim, because he was very, very influential with that. And he just taught me how to be myself. I want to say thank you to him. I love you, man. And this next song we're going to play, he doesn't have any music out, but we're going to play my song. This song, you guys have made it a huge hit. From the bottom of my heart, I want to say thank you so much. You made the video hit. It's got over 100,000 plays, almost 125,000 plays. I want to say thank you so much. You guys have made this a hit. This song was called God is Love. Let's get into it. My latest single this one came out in November. This is called God is Love on Big Old South 20 Countdown. You know what, y'all? Through all the hate that's going on, you gotta remember something. God is love, and love is God. God created love. In the beginning,
on the third day. God created us to be in love, to love our brothers, to love our sisters. That's what we're supposed to do, y'all, because God is love, and love is God. He will be there for you, 'cause you know that God is love. Yeah. No matter what nobody else says, y'all, God created love. Yeah. He wants us to love each other. Stop being a hater. Be a congratulator, y'all. Be a lover, brothers and sisters. That's what God wants us to do. He wants you to love me as I love you. For real. Love. And love is God. He will be there for you, 'cause God is love. Yeah. Say that God is love. And love is God. Say God is love. And love is God. Yeah. We gotta love each other, brothers and sisters. Stop all the hating. That's what it's about. Stop all the procrastinating. Stop all the third party and fourth party stuff. It's not about what political party. It's all about black and white. God created everybody, you know what I'm saying? God is love. Love is God. Let's do the instrumental for a minute. Ooh, God is love. Ooh, yeah. God is love. And love is God. He will be there for you. Yeah. 'Cause God is love. Yeah.
Yeah, y'all, that was God is Love, one of the single that came out in November. Thank you for making this hit. But now let's get back in this countdown. The number three artist of my favorite is the awesome, the very talented Robbie XL. And we're just going to play a little bit of his interview on the show, because I think he was on the fifth season of our show. Let's just do a little snippet of it. Snippet of the interview. Number three, Robbie XL on Big Ooh, Stop 20, 250th episode, part two.
Live with my Robbie XL. How are you, brother?
I'm chilling, man. How's everything, man?
Everything
taking
is awesome.
My time, you know?
Yeah.
Yes,
calling
sir,
from,
yes,
calling
sir.
Us all the way from New Jersey.
West Coast. I'm in the building.
Yeah,
I'm in the building, West Coast.
Yeah, all the way from New Jersey.
Yes, sir, man.
Yeah, brother, what's going on with you? Tell my listeners about yourself.
If you don't know, I'm a public figure. I'm an artist. I wear a lot of different hats, so I'm an artist. First and foremost, I'm an R&B artist. I'm an actor as well. And what people might most know me for right now is my modeling.
Oh, okay.
My thirst traps on Instagram and all of those things
you
like that. I'm
thirst traps.
Yes, sir. I'm a fitness model.
Okay.
Those have been taking off a lot on all different social sites, TikTok, Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter. Pretty much all sites, they're all viral, so it's a blessing right now.
Wow.
So if you guys haven't been following me, it's Robbie, Robbie_XL. Check me out. Give me some of that West Coast love. Show me how y'all do it. And wherever, Midwest, East Coast, whatever, man, all love is welcome.
Yeah. How did you get into modeling?
A really notable photographer discovered me on the internet. It was last January. So prior to that, I fooled around with it a little bit, but I was more so into the music side of things. Mm-hmm. So a photographer by the name of Marvin Benamy was he was on the net, I guess. I went viral on a Tumblr. I don't have a Tumblr, but I went viral on Tumblr. It was a video of me walking down Miami, as I usually do, walking down South Beach. And he posted it. And a couple of friends, a couple of people who already followed me at that time, I had about maybe 18-19K followers. And he reached out to me and he asked me would I be down to do modeling, but the modeling was artistic nude.
Oh,
so it was a big shot. It was a big chance for me to do something other than myself. So, you know, I've always been the type to just, you know, I don't really shy away from anything. I'm not really the shy type.
Okay.
And he was a real professional. So I did that shoot and then I went back and I did another. And then after the first one, I think after the first shoot, it was me and another brother named Fredo. He's really popular on Instagram now too.
Okay.
We collaborated and we went viral for the first time. It was a video of us just walking. And it was one of the silliest things, but it went viral. And after that, it was just like, God just kept that light on me, and then I made videos by myself or random videos of me elsewhere, or South Beach, mostly Miami, and then all of them went viral. And then the fan base just grew and grew and grew, and now I'm almost at 100K followers on Instagram now. So it's wow. Like it's a beautiful thing.
You wouldn't have to teach me how to do that.
Yeah, man, I got you, brother.
I gotta get skinny like you.
Oh, man, I'll show you the way, man.
Oh, man, I'm not mad at you. We're gonna talk more. There. Yeah, y'all, that was the number 17. That was song Najee, Speak Love. We back with my guest, Robbie XL. What's up?
Yes, sir.
I gotta ask a question, man. You didn't feel like you said you weren't shy, but how would you feel like if people saying you nude, people that you grew up with saying you nude? What'd you think about that?
You know, it was you know what? I had to look at it like this, man. Certain things in life, I know everybody has taken chances, and I know everybody who has a dream, they don't want to stay local.
That's true.
And I felt like why would I listen to, you know, local things, like local-minded people? Because anybody who saw my vision would see where I was going with it. It wasn't to just be naked and flaunt things. It was sex sells.
Yeah.
Now, I don't have an OnlyFans account or any of those things.
Okay.
But I, because, you know, I do everything artistic and artistically nude, sometimes regular photo shoots, but the artistic nude and the BTS is a crowd favorite.
Yes.
So I just knew what the people wanted and gave the people what they wanted. And it was kudos to a photographer who, you know, kind of opened that door for me and kind of, you know, had me shy away from being shy because, it's controversial.
Yeah.
But I also know that controversial has, you know, whether it's good or bad, people are going to talk. And as long as they have your name in their mouth, you know, and you're doing something good, it's the right thing. You know, you got to worry about, you know, when they're not talking about you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, y'all. That was just a little bit of our interview with Robbie XL. He's the third artist. He's really an awesome, awesome, awesome artist and singer and stuff like that. We're going to play one of his songs. This song is called Exposure You Lied. Let's get into it on Big Old Stop 20 Countdown.
My love was so profound, you just haven't found it. It's painted on your face, you want some closure. Just to get exposure. But all I ever wanted was some closure. Cause shit too messy. And girl, I'm gonna have to expose you. Why you lie, why you lie? You can cry, you can cry. Why you lie, why? Thinking too much, that's what do we do? But
but you lied to me. You lied to me. No apology. No apology. How you gonna try to play a nigga like me? You don't get no sympathy. You lied. You lied. You lied. You lied. Girl, there ain't no other way around it. You just lucky I ain't never found it. Assumptions. It didn't matter anyway, girl, I meant nothing.
That's how you treated me.
Don't ever think that I'm crying, girl, I ain't on no punction. It's just you lied to me. You lied to me. You lied to me. You lied. You lied. You lied. You lied. Girl, there ain't no other way around it. You just lucky I ain't never found you.
Yeah, y'all, we had to cut that a little bit short because we're running down on time. That was also, that was the number three artist, Robbie XL, was Exposure, You Lied. It's time to get into the number two artist, my number two favorite artist. This episode was absolutely one of my absolute favorites of this podcast. Mark Marcel, I haven't seen him in a long time. We just got together. I just asked him to be on the podcast. He just said, okay. So let's get to my number two favorite artist, Mark Marcel. I'm big. Ooh, stop doing the countdown.
When? I don't know. I can't be reggae. I can't be reggae, man. How you doing? Now we're interviewing our guest, Mark Marcel. What's up, man?
Oh, Lou, what's going on, buddy? How you been, man?
I've been awesome. I've been awesome. This is, I want y'all to know, this is my boy. He's a spoken word artist. He's an actor. He does all over the place. He's an author. He's awesome, man. Y'all tell, Mark, tell my listeners about yourself.
Oh, man, I'm just saying, I've been doing poetry for about a little over 20 years, spoken words, toured all around the world. Now I do the animation with the cartoon. I have gurus, philosophical parodies about the world's greatest philosophers. And, I mean, I guess I would say those are my two biggest ventures. And also, I'm an author. You know, I write books about the philosophy of life. I've got a book called The Book That Doesn't Even Matter. Because it doesn't matter. What matters is the reader. Wow. But, yeah, you know, just that's just what I'm doing, you know, poetry writing and just trying to get, you know, positive content.
Yeah. That's awesome.
Stress people's minds.
You said that all cool, like, oh, it's just another thing I'm doing. Oh, it's just part of my life.
You know, I mean,
it's just nothing. I'm just like breathing.
I'm trying to be humble about it, man. You know, there's nothing special about me other than the hours that I put in. You know what I'm saying? Anybody can do it, you know?
Y'all don't know, this man is really, really special. Ever since I knew him, I've been knowing him for like 13 years. We met over at the, when I was working at the Sentinel. This man has always been, I said, I mean, you know what? This man is somebody. I got to interview him.
I appreciate that, man. Yeah, I remember that. You interviewed me on the spot.
Yeah, this man has always been, he's awesome. How did you get into, we're going to start with the spoken word. How did you get into doing spoken word?
Long story short, spoken word. Well, I'm a novelist at heart. I was writing novels, and this is before I was even out there. Nobody knew I was writing novels. I was just in the closet writing novels. No one knew that. Decided, I was like, you know, I want to write a poem at the end of one of my books.
Okay.
And, just to tell what the book was about. Long story short, I took that poem to class one day because I needed extra credit. And the teacher went, with the extra credit assignment, it was like, bring your poem and read it in this open mic thing on campus. Mm-hmm. I was late for that, actually, and I didn't get to read it. But I was like, come on, Mr. Yancey, come on, Mr. Yancey, please, please, I'm writing, blah, blah, blah. I'm a writer. I've been doing all this, and here's a poem. And he was like, oh, "Man, let me see this. Let me see what you're talking about." So he just looked at my poem, and then he looked at me, looked at the poem, looked at me. He was like, "Bring this to class tomorrow." And I was like, "All right, can I still get the extra credit?" He's like, "Man, bring this to class tomorrow." I'm like, "No, you can't get the extra credit."
There was
only 10 minutes left in the hour thing. He's like, "Man, get out of here." So I took the poem the next day to his class, and he stopped his curriculum and taught the class my poetry. Holy he stopped not just that day, but after the end of the class, he was like, "You got any more of these?" I was like, "Yeah." Wow. And then he stopped teaching his class for 2 weeks. Wow. And I was in a poetry class. We was learning about Langston Hughes and all these people, and he stopped teaching them that for 2 weeks, was teaching them the poetry that I was writing. And from that encouraged me to think or believe that, hey, maybe I'm onto something here. You know, maybe this isn't just, maybe I should expose it a little more. And he told me to go find a professor on a campus that I never did. It just went in one ear and out the other. And then 4 months later, I was out at a comedy club, and they announced the professor's name on stage. And I was like, yo, that's a dude that my teacher told me to go holler at. And I went and talked to him, and I was like, hey, you know, I've got this book, writing books, and I've got some poetry and stuff. And he was like, come to my office tomorrow. And I did. And I just wanted to help get him published. But he instead took me to the poetry venues. And I remember the first time I read a poem, the first time I recited a poem, I was reading the poem, and I was reading the wrong lines from the poem. And so, yeah, I was just nervous and stuff. So, yeah, that's kind of how I got into it. He kept on pushing me. You know, he was like, well, get on out there, read it, you know. And I remember one time I came to the venue that he was hosting, and I was like, yeah, I'm just going to be here and post up and just see. He was like, man, you better be ready. I'm going to call you. And I was like, oh, shit. So I, like, went to go write something real quick. So, I mean, you had people like that in my life when I was early that would encourage me to keep pushing. So that's kind of how I got into the game.
Wow, that is so...
Yeah, y'all. We had to give you just a little snippet of Mark Marcel's episode, but he didn't stop there. He also did his spoken word. We played one of his spoken word pieces. We're going to get into one of his spoken word pieces that he played on the show. He actually was on the show. Let's get into it. Mark Marcel's spoken word. I forgot the name of this, but let's play it. He's number 2 on Big Ooh, Stop 20, 250th episode.
Mark Marcel with Every Moment.
It's very simple. This is what I believe, and I'm willing to die for it.
Nevertheless,
period.
I've got to give it a try. Otherwise, what have I been doing? 3 years. At least you'll go out since I've been able to eat.
Every moment of your life, you decide the person you want to be. Every day you open your eyes, the first compromise you make with life are the limitations of what you think you can. Strange how reality makes you settle on your dreams, even though it just got finished reminding you while you were asleep that you can be anything. But how quickly do we forget that yesterday doesn't have to dictate who we are today? So we become our routine. The person you think you are is just a person you are presently addicted to being. Some habits are good, like breathing. Others are a slow way of dying. The kind that have you convincing yourself mountains are too high to climb. So you throw the ideas to the back of your mind without even trying. Afraid of failure and a loss of time. Ironically failing without even trying. But that person was yesterday, doesn't have to be here today. So what you need to ask yourself is, who do you want to be right now? Every moment of your life, make a decision. Are you aiming for the moon or the stars? Or something beyond it that others' imagination can't even conceive in it. But just as long as you believe in it, you can reach it.
He told the guy, when you want to succeed as bad as you want to breathe, then you'll be successful. Most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it.
Every moment, every second, every minute, every hour, every moment of the day. You have a choice to make.
Greatness is not this feature that only the special among us will ever taste. You know, it's something that truly exists in all of us. We make this situation more complex than it has to be.
Because we're looking for complexity. There's got to be something complex to understand.
It can't be that easy.
So who are you going to be? I can't, too old, too fat, too slow. Who cares? Why are you letting others decide what your definitions mean to you? Whose standards are you trying to live up to? Yours or theirs? It's time to stop letting yourself down. Tomorrow isn't promised to you, so you should stop lying to yourself. Depending on the sunrise and in the morning, you got a perfectly good sun right now. So who are you going to be? Nikola Tesla must have asked himself. Maybe Albright asked his brother Will, but who are we going to be right now? I imagine Malcolm X looked in the mirror just after coming home from Egypt and asked himself, who are you going to be right now?
greatness does not come easy. Albert Einstein was sitting in his room for weeks, months, years in solitude, thinking on concepts of relativity. Every moment, every second, he had a choice to make. You settle for the lemons, or you make lemonade. You can either be ordinary, or you can be great. And I see way too many dreams and bottles tossed to the wayside in the perfect place to be forgotten. Malt with stickers of what I could have been, and all because they never even tried. Those days are yesterday, those days are gone, those days have died. There's a new you get the chance to be. And the person that doesn't believe in you is standing right next to the one that knows you can do some extraordinary things. So who are you gonna be? This is your moment to choose. Are you gonna stand there looking at mountains? Or do you believe mountains only exist so they can be moved?
Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep. Some of you love sleep more than you love success. If you're going to be successful, you've got to be willing to give up sleep.
Every moment, every second, every minute, every hour, every moment of the day. You have a choice to make.
We didn't grow up with the sense that where we were was where we were going to be. You know, we grew up with the sense that where we were almost didn't matter because we were becoming something greater. I just believe that I can create whatever I want to create.
Yeah, y'all, that was the awesome number two artist, Marc Marcel. Now we have made it to the pole position. My number one favorite guest of my podcast is Aretha Jones. She was so fantastic. She was just on earlier this season. And I must say, it's one of my very favorite podcasts. And she was really, really funny. We're going to get just a snippet of her episode that she did. Let's get into it. Aretha Jones, my number one favorite guest on Big Ooh Stop 2250th episode.
We're talking to the legendary Aretha Jones. Yes, the legendary. I say legendary. She doesn't like it when I say that. But yeah, legendary. Yeah, funny. Aretha Jones, you know what? I had a couple of weeks ago, if you guys recall, we did a comedy corner with Aretha Jones on it. And it was, I mean, very, very funny. I'm not just saying that because you're here. I was telling you, usually when I play comedy corners, I just rarely laugh. But I played your comedy corner that you did on the Tom Joyner show. 9 minutes of funny. Oh my God, it was so funny. I mean, I was like, wow. And I also got to meet her, was it like 2 or 3 months ago at Robert Vargas's comedy party? Was it there? We were in downtown, I remember. I remember that.
Oh, yeah, yes. Yeah, that was, wasn't that Garrett Morris? No.
No, that was Robert Vargas's party. And you remember Abraham Bucci was there. I was there. And I sang my song. And I sang my song, Uplifted. We're in the comedy room. Yeah.
Yes, that. Oh, yes. Yeah. Oh, my God. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't know what I was doing there.
I think it was only 2 or 3 people in the audience.
Right. It was so fun. It was fun, and I was trying to get people to come back in that little room. That thing was so cute. That was Mark Edwards is the one that just called me and says, can you come down here and do some comedy? Yeah. And so I didn't understand what was really happening, but yeah, it was a lot of fun. It turned out to be fun.
It really did turn out to be fun. I got to meet you. I was like, wow. I really didn't realize how fun you were until I looked at your clips later on. I said, man. Oh my God, she is a wow, funny. And you also did some acting too. I saw you on 101.
Yeah, I was on 101. That was an okay clip. I'm more proud of my show that I did on Strong Medicine. I did like 2 or 3 of those. I was a sort of a recurring, but it was just to be one of the women in her little circle. But yeah, I started out trying to be an actor. That's what I was doing on the Beauty Shop play, but I realized I'm not that good at acting. I'm better now than I used to be, only because of the comedy.
Okay.
And I'm telling you the truth. So last night, now we're talking about my life as a female comic. I felt like last night and this whole weekend, but last night I did Chocolate Sunday at the Laugh Factory. First time in like, since 5 or 6 years ago. I hadn't done that in years. And wow. So I was there and all the comedians just show up and hang out and whatever. And they were coming to me left and right, giving me hugs, telling me, oh my God, Rita, it's so good to see you. You're so good and blah, blah, blah. It was the reception I got, and most were men. So that's another thing about being a female comic. If you're struggling, if you're still trying to build your show, I've heard the complaint from women throughout the years, how come these men ain't giving women no love and whatever. I'm like, it's not that they don't give women love. It's that you have to be funny to them. Once they think you're funny, they will start booking you, because Melina Camacho don't have a problem. Hope Flood never had a problem. Angela Means never had a problem. AJ Sanders never had a problem. So when the fun, you have to talk to the fun chicks. So I worked on being funny. And last night I had so much fun on that stage, two shows. And them guys were just so nice to me. And that's what I feel like. I felt like what you said, legend. I feel like I'm an old cat in the game. That's what I am.
Yeah.
But it is one of those things that you just got to work on. And I'm trying to be better. And the I was going to say the comedy, just trying to free myself and get out of my head.
Yeah.
That's happening to me now.
Oh, wow.
I'm perfectly sure that once I get back into acting, it's going to be a piece of cake, because I'm no longer in my head anymore. I'm just letting comedy happen to me. And to the point where I can't even stick to my set list, because I'll think of something else funny and just go with that.
Wow, that is so cool. But you guys, we're gonna talk more to our guest, Aretha. Let's get to the number 14 song. You guys, that was just a snippet of our really awesome number one guest, Aretha Jones, man. But you guys, let's get into 3 minutes for comedy. Let's do a comedy. My number one favorite guest. This is Aretha Jones.
But look, I'm single. I know, huh? I'm tired of it being implied that single people are lonely. Y'all stop that bullshit. I am not lonely. I got 4 cats, 3 dogs, and a vibrator with a AC cord hooked up to a generator, goddammit. I knocked the power out in my neighborhood again. You know what I'm saying. I was actually thinking, you know, a lot of women my age, they say, oh, girl, you don't look too bad. You date a younger man. I'm like, you can't. You got to be in shape. Young men want you to do everything they hear them rap artists talk about. You remember Usher's album, that record when Ludacris on there, he said, I want a lady in the street and a freak in the bed. Look, I'm a lady in the street and a sleep in the bed. I gotta go to work in the morning, all right? Gotta get in shape for their ass. I'm scared, I got too many issues. A little 24-year-old ran up on me after a show one night. You know what, baby, for real though? You need to get with a young buck like me, baby. Look, I tear this stuff up. I said, look, that's the problem. This stuff already tore up. Okay? I got a bad back. I done had surgeries and dry and shit. And I can't even get on top. I got bad knees. If you try to get on top, you forget you got bad knees. Get up there and get locked up on his ass trying to do some porn shit. I got up there trying to be like I'm trying to pretend I can do it. I'm up there just rolling. I forgot I got osteoarthritis. And shit kicked right in. I got locked. Bam! Oh, sorry. Oh, look, stop. Did you hear something pop? No, it wasn't that coochie. Shut up. This ain't a rap. It was my knees. Okay, look, you got some icy hot or something in the house? Look, go in there and ask your mama if she got some icy hotter. Thank you, guys. I've been Aretha Jones. Thank you for supporting Pretty Funny Women.
Yeah, y'all, that was the number one artist and her, my number one favorite guest, Aretha Jones. I want to say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you to everyone who's been with me for the past 7 seasons, the past 250 shows. I love every single one of you all. Kill Radio, Small Motion Radio, The Block FM, Spotify, Apple Music. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Every listener, everybody who supported. You guys just don't know that, you know, this is awesome that you guys have helped me make it to 250. I love every single one of you guys. But you guys, we're in the midst of the celebration. And, oh, thought for the week. Keep going strong, and you will always succeed. And we usually play a gospel song. This is our gospel song for the week. This song is called Celebration of Grace, my song. God bless, God keep you, until we meet again.
Every now and then, we just gotta celebrate God's goodness. Come on, y'all. God the glory, 'cause he's been so good. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. My table, keep it clothes on my back. Gave me a job, helped me find my family. Been so good to me, y'all. So I just gotta give him all the praise. I'm gonna dance while I have the chance, y'all. 'Cause he's been so good. Yeah, oh Lord,
celebrate.